Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video, we're gonna take a different look on how to create art with micro displacement in Blender. Because most of the time, you just displace a plane with a noise texture and then render it from the top. But with using certain displacement maps and displacing it a little bit stronger, you can get results like this one. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get straight into the video. For the displacement maps, I'm using a software called Chaotica. There is a free version of it, and I will link it in the video description. Basically, you just get these backgrounds, which are procedurally generated, and you can click on them, and they will just load in the program, and you can then click on File, Save Image. And with the free version, you can save this image with a 1K texture resolution. Okay, once you've exported this image, we can open Blender. Firstly, let's set up our scene. This means let's add in a plane, switch over to Cycles, Experimental, and for me, I'm gonna use GPU Compute. And now let's give the plane a subdivision surface modifier, set to Simple and Adaptive. This will just allow us to use micro displacement. Also add a new material, and in the settings of the material, change the displacement to displacement only. Okay, let's open another window, go to the shader editor, split it again, and go to World. We can then add in an environment texture. And because I want this render to be bright, I will use a bright environment texture, which is the Photo Studio from HDRI Heaven. Let's load this in and connect it to our color. And if we go into rendered mode, you can see that our HDRI has loaded incorrectly. But we're just gonna go under film and check transparent, because we don't really need it. Okay, next you can locate your image and just drag and drop it into Blender. And if we preview this, you can see that it works perfectly. For this tutorial, I will use this image. Okay, for the color, we can just put it in the base color, and now we have the color of our plane. The displacement is also really easy. We can just add in a displacement node, and then plug the color into the height input, and also plug the displacement output in the displacement input of the material output. And just like this, you get this kind of a displacement. You can see that the plane gets moved down, and this is because of the mid-level. If we change this to 0, the plane stays where it was previously and only gets displaced upwards. Okay, let's add in our camera. You can already see that most of the displacement is happening in this area right here, so we can just add in our camera, but I will first split these windows in half again, press T so we hide this panel right here, and then uncheck both of these, and we can also right-click on the header and disable Show Header, just like this. Now we can add in our camera, press Ctrl Alt and 0, and go into rendered mode in the upper window. In this window, we also want to press 0 to go into camera view. We can now change the camera's placement in the bottom window. Let's just position our camera in a way that it's facing upwards to our displacement, just like this. You can now probably see that the displacement is really low res, and this is because of the subdivision preview rate. If we change this down to 1, we basically get the same displacement as in our renders, and this actually looks really nice. For the background, I will just use a simple white plane, so add in a plane, scale it up, and we can also rotate it so this edge is parallel to our camera, like this. And we can also select this edge extruded upwards, so we get a simple background. Now let's just go into rendered mode, and you can see that we get this scene. We can also enable render region to just get what we will actually render out. So there's one thing I want to add, and this is some nice bokeh. So let's select our camera, enable depth of field and the limits display. And now let's move the distance really close to the camera to the place where the displacement is actually happening. For example, just like this, and we can go back into rendered mode, and to really see this bokeh, we can change the f-stop down to, for example, 1. And we can play with our distance slider till we get a result that we like. Now, the last thing we want to do is go into the passes tab and check denoising data, and we will also turn down the render resolution to 32, because this will give us a nice painterly look once we denoise this render. Okay, let's just hit F12 and render our image. Okay, finally, after 22 minutes, our image has been rendered. This takes a very long time, and this is also a reason why you want to turn down your sample count, and you can really see that it has affected our render. So let's get rid of it. So head over to the compositing tab, check use nodes, and with the node wrangler add-on enabled, we can just control shift click on the render layers node to get our render as our background. With V you can scale down your backdrop, and with Alt V you can scale it up. Okay, so let's add an AD noise node. Plug the noisy image into the image input, the normal into the normal input, and the albedo in the albedo input. And again, we can preview this node. And this gives us our final render. You can see that we get this nice painterly look in our image. And yeah, that's basically it. If you like this tutorial, consider subscribing and liking. And we're gonna see us next Saturday in the next video.